forever could never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Mary, today and every day, marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will.
There's no disease that enough love will not heal. No door that enough love will not bridge. No wall that enough love will not throw down. No sin that enough love will not redeem. It makes no difference how deeply seated may be the trouble, how hopeless the outlook, how muddled the tangle or great the mistake. A sufficient realization of love will dissolve it all. If only you could love enough, you could be the happiest person in the world. Tanner and Katie, real love can bring you through anything. Katie, would you please take Tanner's hands in yours and hold them palms up so you can see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend. Young, strong, and vibrant with love, holding yours on your wedding day, as he promises to love you all the days of his life. These are the hands that work alongside yours as together you build your future. As you laugh and cry and share your innermost secrets and dreams, these are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. They are the hands that will comfort you in illness and then hold you when fear or grief fill your mind. These are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into his eyes. Eyes that are filled completely with his overwhelming love and desire for you. Now, Tanner, please hold Katie's hands palms up so you can see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, smooth, young, and carefree, holding yours on your wedding day as she pledges her love and commitment to you all the days of her life. These are the hands that will hold each child in tender love, soothing them through illness and hurt, supporting and encouraging them along the way, and then knowing when it is time to let go. They're also the hands that will massage the tension from your neck and your back in the evenings after you both had a long, hard day. No pressure, Katie. These are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times together. They are the hands that will comfort you when you're sick and console you when you're grieving. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will give you support as Katie encourages you to chase down your dreams. Together, as a team, everything you wish for can be realized. Let's pray one last time. God, we pray that you would bless the hands that you see before you this day. May they always be held by one another. Give them the strength to hold on during the storms of stress or the dark of disillusionment. We ask that you would keep them tender and gentle as they nurture each other in their wondrous love. Help their hands to continue building a relationship that is founded in your grace, rich and caring and devoted in reaching for your perfection. May Tanner and Katie see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. And now do you, Tanner, take Katie to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto her as long as you both shall live. And do you, Katie, take Tanner to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto him as long as you both shall live. And Tanner, please repeat after me. I, Tanner.
I, Tanner.
Take you, Katie.
Take you, Katie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
Partner in life.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today.
Love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever. I will trust you.
I will trust you.
And honor you.
Honor you.
I will laugh with you.
I'll laugh with you.
And cry with you.
Cry.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
What may come,
I will always be there.
I will always be there.
As I have given you my hands to hold.
As I have given you my hands to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Katie, please repeat after me. I, Katie, take you, Tanner, to be my husband. My partner in life. And my one true love. I will cherish our friendship. And love you today, tomorrow, and forever. I will trust you. And honor you. I will laugh with you. And cry with you. Like right now. Can you work up a couple of tears? I will love you faithfully, through the best and the worst, through the difficult and the easy. What may come, I will always be there. As I have given you my hands to hold, so I give you my life to keep. So help me God. May I have the rings? At this time, our couple will exchange rings as a symbol and pledge of their love for one another. Just as the rings have no end and they go on and on, so should your love have no end, you too should go on and on. Most rings are made of gold symbolizing purity. May your marriage be one of purity, and you keep only to one another in the marriage. And then years from now, as you look down at your hand and you see the ring, may it remind you of this moment as you stood right here before God, friends, and family with your promise to love. Place that on the bride's hand and repeat after me. Katie, today we move from I to we.
Wear this ring
as a symbol of our decision
to join our lives
together.
With this ring,
I pledge myself to you
with all the affections of my heart
as long as we both shall live. Place that on your groom's hand. Tanner, today we move from I to we. Wear this ring as a symbol of our decision to join our lives together. With this ring, I pledge myself to you with all the affections of my heart as long as we both shall live. On the barrel behind me, there's a special box with a bottle of wine inside that was chosen by our couple. Our bride and groom have also written love letters to each other, expressing their feelings as they begin their marriage. They've detailed why they fell in love and what they truly admire about one another. In just a moment, they will place the letters in the box, and we will seal them inside. And then, on the occasion of their fifth wedding anniversary, they will open the box, enjoy a glass of wine, read the contents of the letters, and celebrate 5 years of marriage. Share with you all, in an effort to keep the ceremony nice and short due to the heat, I attempted to convince Tanner to skip the next part of the ceremony, the kissing of the bride. But as you can imagine, he was extremely determined that we not leave that part out. And so he argued with me for a while. We went back and forth. I eventually gave in. I'm happy to say to you now, let me kiss your bride. Mr. and Mrs. Tanner Acord.
Drawing me in and you keep
kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine.
Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did. Turning into moms and dads, next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think.
For Katie and her father, Don.
I turned on the evening news, saw an old man being interviewed, turning 102 today. I asked him what's the secret to life. He looked up from his old pie, laughed and said, all I can say is, don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25. Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Tanner.
Thanking Katie, of course, for even letting Tanner make me the best man, because from being completely honest, I really have no idea why she still even lets him hang out with me. We made some pretty stupid choices over the last few years, but yeah. But then again, you know, look at what you have over here. You know, it's not like you got a whole lot to choose from, so yeah.
You're definitely the best choice.
yeah. So sorry, guys. And then. But yeah, so I know many of you are expecting me to stand up here and, you know, tell a funny story about Tanner, like a drunken escapade, or like maybe something that'll like really embarrass him. But I just don't really feel like that is something that's needed tonight. Plus, you know him, you already have a ton of those anyway, so won't matter. No point to add to it. No. Instead, I want to tell you about the time that Tanner actually told me about Katie about 3.5 years ago for the first time. I was out of town one weekend, and I had just gotten back, and I get this call from Tanner, and I can just tell right off the bat that he's really, really excited. Like, bro, like, hey, man, I went out to the bars this weekend, and I met this girl, and I got a phone number, and, oh, man, she's in the 85 sorority, and she's just really, really hot. I'm paraphrasing too, because I know Tanner has in-laws now, and we're just gonna let that go. Respect. Anyway, so I'm sitting here, and I'm just like, what? I'm just over here, just like, wow, Tanner, you know, that's really good for you, man. Like, I'm really happy for you, man. So he's like, yeah, man. You know, I'm really excited about her too. Hey, and by the way, what are you doing tonight? You know, what do you need, man? Like, maybe you could spare a few hours. He goes, well, 85 formal is coming up, and this girl Katie, she already has another date to it. Some other loser from another fraternity. And I really want her to take me. So I'm not really liking where this conversation's going. I'm like, well, all right, what do you want from me, man? He goes, all right, tonight, let's go to 80 Pie's meeting, and we'll get up on stage, and we'll give a presentation about our company, and then, you know, we'll get a bunch of FaceTime in front of the girls, and Joe, I'm sure you'll get a day, and, you know, I mean, then Katie will see me standing up there, and then she'll ditch the dude she's taken to formal already, and then take me. So I'm sitting over here and just like, you know, like thinking about that. I'm like, all right, Tanner, so what you want from me is to go with you to meeting tonight and stand up with you on stage in front of about 100 girls, throw some BS out there about a make-believe company that just does not exist.
On the did off, at one time.
On the off chance that this girl that you met one time will ditch her current date and take you instead. And, I mean, I'm just saying, looking at it, looking at the two of you up here right now, all these years later, I still have no idea how that dumbass plan worked out so well. I mean, jeez, man. But nailed it, right? I guess, you know, unlike a lot of, like, my friends who bring girls around, I never felt like she was, you know, taking Tanner away or anything. You know, it was more like, I was gaining another best friend. And, you know, I really want to thank you for that, Katie. You know, it really means a lot, you know, how you really shared him with us. So, I just have to say, from the beginning, your guys' relationship has always impressed me. And, I just am really looking forward to watching the life that you two build together. So, if we can, on that note, everyone that has one, can we please raise a glass to Tanner and Katie Accord? Congratulations, you guys.
My name is Kristen. Some people call me Chrissy. One very special person calls me Sissy. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Katie's big sister. Before I get started, I would like to thank my parents and Tanner's parents for making this celebration possible. When I think about our life as sisters, I remember back to that September day when my 8-year-old self was anxiously awaiting your arrival, hoping you were a girl one and not a boy one. And I remember taking a class on how to be a big sister, and proudly sporting my big sister button at the hospital. And I remember immediately loving you and wanting to help mom take care of you. I always wanted to watch out for you and protect you, even though we both know that you killed the spiders for me. I came crawling into your bed at night when I couldn't sleep. I remember how hard it was to move across the country because I was afraid I was going to miss out on watching you grow up. And after years of visiting and talking on the phone, I was glad, so thankful to finally be close to you again. And I got to watch you take on this amazing new role as Auntie Katie to my boys. And they just love you beyond words. And they broke you in real good with trips to urgent care for staples in the head and locking the door so you can't leave when you come to visit. And it's so obvious you have an amazing heart for children. And then I remember you telling me about some new model guy that you met. I think he wanted to be like the next Ryan Seacrest or something like that. And I remember thinking, okay, so John and I were very excited to meet your new beau. And Tanner, as soon as we met you, we could see that you were someone special. And we were thrilled to see how happy you have made my sister and why she loves you so much. And the more you came around, we grew to love you too. We knew you must be the one for our Katie. The boys knew it too, because every time I tell them Auntie Katie's coming over, their immediate follow-up question has become, is Tanner coming too? And with that, the boys would like to say a little something.
Hi, Tanner, Daddy's dog.
He likes Superman.
Tanner, be like Iron Man because he is cool.
Tanner, be like Spider-Man because he is smart.
Tanner, be like Captain America because he is a selfless leader. And we got you a little something to remind you to be a superhero and to take good care of our Auntie Katie. Welcome to the fam, Uncle T.
Oh my god. That's so cute.
Let's all raise a glass to the happy couple. Congratulations. Cheers.
Cheers. Woo!
things you don't play around. Cover much grounds, got game all the time. Getting paid is a forte, each and every day. True play away, I can't get her out of my mind.
Wow,
I think about the girl all the time.
Wow, wow.
I like the way you work it,
no diggity.
I got to bag it up for you.
Woo!
I like the way you work it.
Take your time, man. No worries.
Wow, look, Mom, no hands. Or don't look, Mom, no hands. I just got it.
One. Don't drop that dude. Two. Three. Nice. Hey, how about that?
Right on.
Yeah. Greg's next!
Everyone's
hey now!
Vampire boys!
Vampire boys!
Yeah.